Hey guys, here we are at a friend's farm to do IMO3. Here's a list of some of the things you'll need before you get started. Having those on hand is a great way to save yourself the trouble of looking for things once you get started. First thing you'll need is your food source for your IMO. Today we're using my industry's byproduct, which is a carbon-to-carbon of macadamia nut shell and macadamia nut kernel. These are the two things you'll need. In All About IMO, we'll talk about the various things you can use for making IMO3. You can use all kinds of things, so don't feel limited because you don't have what I'm using. I don't have what my teacher was using, so here we are. Go ahead and prepare your site. Get a cool, dry place if you can. Dirt floor is ideal. Making it on concrete causes some problems, but anything's possible, guys. Go ahead and get your material in one clean, nice pile if you can. We'll make a puka in the center or a hole in the center for our water as we get started. Now let's work on what's going in our water. Here's a simple spreadsheet I use for my ingredient list. If you don't have some of these materials, don't worry about it. Anything's possible, you can do all of this. These are helpful, and we'll explain why in About IMO. But for now, we're gonna use fermented plant juice, brown rice vinegar, OHN, Oriental Herbal Nutrient, seawater, IMO2 or IMO4T, humic acid, and water. This is about 40 pounds, so in about 40 pounds you need about 2 gallons of water, and that's also dependent on your moisture in your environment and the temperature and all that. So you're going to have to play with that ratio. I found this is a successful ratio for me. Let's get these materials into our water and get started. So for a measuring device today, we have a baby bottle. Use whatever you can. So for Oriental Herbal Nutrients, we want 0.1 ounce. So it's very little. And this is a 3-year-old Oriental Herbal Nutrient. Don't worry about that. It's just a lesser amount if it's older. Oriental Herbal Nutrient goes in. Fermented plant juice, 0.5 ounces. Humic acid, 1 ounce. This is store-bought humic acid, so we're going to use 0.5 as it's a little more potent than worm humic acid. Again, if you don't have any of these, don't worry about it. Best if you do, though. We'll talk about that in About IMO. Brown rice vinegar, 0.5 ounces. Ocean water. I'm going to use 8 ounces of this. There's 6. And 2. A little extra ocean water never hurts. You want to use another couple ounces, go for it. Go ahead and stir that around with your hand. Now, for adding the IMO2, as we made in the other video, clean hand going in, small handful, and that's all you need for inoculating this entire pile. You want to use extra? You can use extra, but you really don't need it. It's a small amount. And that will seed all of this material and it'll grow out, just like making bread or various other things. So there's all our ingredients combined in water. Next step is to add the water to the pile. Add it little by little so it doesn't all run away from you. And you're gonna have to feel how much moisture is necessary in your material to get it to the right moisture. There's not a perfect amount for that. The ratio I gave you is helpful, but you're gonna have to figure that out on your own. I'll give you some tips on how to do that, and there's more on the moisture content in the video about IMO. All right, we finished our pile, we finished mixing. We have a good bit of moisture in here, but not so much that I can squeeze out a bunch of liquid. Just enough that I can get some moisture to show up between my fingers. It's a bit of work. And if you make a really big pile, it's even more work. So if this seems like a lot, grab some friends. Or if you're a big industrial farmer or you have a ton of land and you're scratching your head on how you're gonna do this on a large scale, check out some of my videos where I talk about my large scale applications and some of the tricks and ways I've kept the quality but increased in scale. So now that we have a little bit of moisture, about 70% moisture is what we're going through, but that doesn't mean a whole lot because how are you gonna measure a percentage of moisture? Practically speaking, squeeze it, it's not, water's not falling out, but you can get some liquid in between your fingers. That's about as close as I can tell you. What you're gonna have to do is experiment on your own and come up with the right amount of moisture for your material in your environment so that it doesn't go anaerobic or become real ammonia smelling or have no activity at all because it stayed too dry. Next, ideally you wanna cover it with something. If you have a grass mat or some dry grass that you cut down, you can use all that. I'm gonna use, again, a byproduct from what I have readily available, and this is a macadamia nut husk. And it's just a dry, kind of grass-like material, and I'm just gonna cover the whole pile here. Give it a nice coating, and that's it. Your IMO3 is finished and ready to wait to be turned tomorrow. Always turn it one day after, even if it doesn't heat up or show signs of activity. I find that 36 hours approximately after you first make it, you have a first spike of real increased activity. And what you don't want to do is check it 48 hours later and have it went too hot and you weren't paying attention. So go ahead and turn it day one, no matter what, and then see how it's going day two and day three. But ideally you want to come turn this every day until the activity or the temperature drops back down. For checking temperature, you can use a thermometer, but these are kind of expensive and really you can put your hand in and say that's hot or that's warm and go ahead and turn it when that shows up. So Pretty easy to do. Just try it out, get started. The only way to learn is to begin. Thanks for watching IMO3. We'll see you next week to add dirt and make IMO4.